Will all chorus members please join the chorus? Ladies and gentlemen, we ask that you please rise for the presentation of the colors by our award-winning Air Force Junior ROTC Color Guard and the Pledge of Allegiance. We also ask that you remain standing for our choir's presentation of our national anthem.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please be seated. Thank you, Mr. Katona and the members of our Jackson Liberty Line Band, Mrs. Young and members of our choir. Good afternoon, families and friends of the graduates of the class of 2022. As a student council co-president, I've been given the honor to be the first to welcome you to the 14th annual commencement exercise ceremony to honor the Jackson Liberty High School class of 2022. At this time, I would like to invite Senior Class President Emma Canis to the podium to offer their words of welcome.
Good evening, friends, family, faculty, Board of Education members, and those watching the JTV live stream. I'd like to take a moment and thank you all for attending tonight to honor the class of 2022 and all that we have accomplished these past 4 years. Before I dive into my speech and make the moms out there cry, especially mine, I just want to take a moment to thank all those that made today possible. Mrs. Permilli, along with the rest of the Board of Education, who made not only today possible, but almost our entire senior year. Mr. Brignola and the administrative staff here at Liberty, who have helped this day run smoothly and every other day of our high school career. And finally, our two class advisors from this year, Mrs. Cavanaugh and Ms. Weir, who have made ice cream sandwiches at prom and a bouncy house obstacle course at senior day happen. 4 years ago, September 6th, 2018, our families waved goodbye to us as we walked toward the bus stop. It was our first day of high school. We were younger, shorter, more annoying, and clueless. We had no idea what the next 4 years would have in store for us. When our entire class was pulled into the auditorium for a meeting, a Get to Know Jackson Liberty seminar, if you will, one of the first things Mr. Brignola said was that these 4 years go by so fast. I sat there for the rest of the assembly, thinking about 4 years into the future. Me, walking the football field with all 305 of you. I couldn't wait for this day, leaving Liberty and leaving Jackson. But now as I stand here, I can't believe that I'm saying goodbye to the place I call home. Now, class of 2022, I want you to take a moment and think about our past 4 years here. I want you to remember about those times you complained about the walk from the gym all the way to your language class, or those pasta Fridays where you ran down to the lunchroom to get the last tray of fettuccine Alfredo. I want you to think about rushing the field freshman year when we won the Don Connor Trophy, the band performing amazing shows at halftime and then winning states the very next day. Seeing your friends perform at the spring musical, helping out at the Fronies, visiting the school store to eat lunch with Mrs. Capasso, talking to Mr. Patterson in the hallway for 5, 10, 20 minutes before class. Think about working hard to ace your test in AP Gov, Honors English, or Algebra 1. Walking through the halls of Liberty once more. After we take our diplomas, we are no longer students of Jackson Liberty High School. We aren't going to come back next fall expecting a senior year 2.0. This school and its teachers and staff have built a foundation for us. We'll go on to do amazing things in life, building off what we have learned here. You see, no matter what we do, where we go, Liberty will always be our home, always a spot to connect us all together. So, whatever emotion you're feeling now, know that we all feel it too. I wish you all the best in whatever your future may hold for you. And once a lion, always a lion. Thank you.
Thank you, Emma. I would like to introduce some of the honored guests that you see here this afternoon. From our Board of Education, Board President, Mr. Michael Walsh. Board of Education Vice President, Ms. Tara Rivera. Board of Education members, Ms. Allison Barocas, Mr. Giuseppe Palmieri, Mr. Scott Sargent, Jackson Township Mayor, Mr. Michael Reyna, Jackson Township Council President, Mr. Martin Fleming, Jackson Township Councilman, Mr. Andrew Kern, and the Jackson Liberty High School administrative team, led by our principal, Mr. Jeff Brignola, and assistant principals, Mr. David Bender, Mr. Kyle Brunson, and Mr. Mark Lax. At this time, I would like to call our superintendent of schools, Ms. Nicole Permilli, to the podium for our superintendent's address.
Thank you, Samantha.
Good afternoon, everyone. This class of 2022 has grown up in a world that neither I nor I'm sure your parents could have imagined when we were kids. And I'm not referring to the pandemic. Right around this time you were born, Mark Zuckerberg launched Facebook from his Harvard dorm room. When you were being potty trained, Twitter founder Jack Dempsey sent out his first tweets. When you hit kindergarten, these things called iPads were changing the world, and Instagram was born to make people like me and your parents, who just got a handle on Facebook, feel old instantly. And by the time you were allowed to have your own phone, you were dancing, singing, posing, and posting on Musical.ly, which eventually became TikTok. And you were off, leaving us all in the dust. While you were in school and exploring US history and algebra,
NASA's Spirit of Opportunity rovers were busy exploring Mars and finding evidence that Mars may once have been able to sustain life. And just before spring break of this year, your senior year, NASA Hubble Space Telescope broke one of its own records by discovering the most distant star ever. A star whose light has taken 12.9 billion years to reach us. The astronomer and lead author of the paper of this discovery said it was like scientists were reading a really interesting book. But we started with the second chapter, and now we will have a chance to see how it all got started. This is the way all of us here today feel about you. We are witnessing your star as it blazes into your next mission. We are marveling at what you have overcome. You were resilient when you should not have had to be. You leaned on each other, and your empathy and love for your fellow classmates shined as bright as a star again and again. I want to thank every teacher and administrator, every support office staff member, food service, transportation, security, technology, our facilities team members, every staff member who supported you on your journey. We are all sharing in this moment of pride with you. I want to thank our parents and family members who have been with us every step of the way. There is no greater satisfaction than watching you launch into your bright futures. Graduates, we are so excited to be celebrating all that you have accomplished and so eager to see what you will reveal to us as we watch you through our telescopes. For you, technology is not new, it just is. Life-changing products and advancements are not unreachable. They happen every day. Discoveries that inspire awe are taking place right in front of you now. Remember that the Hubble scientists I mentioned? They called their newly discovered star Arendelle, which means morning star. It is said to hold promise for opening up an uncharted era. And as I look at it, all of you here today, I realize I couldn't have said it better myself. Good luck to you as you continue to shine and reach for the stars. I hope you recognize that nothing is impossible. The unimaginable is possible. Congratulations to the class of 2022. It is my pleasure to introduce the Board of Education President, Mr. Walsh.
Welcome. On behalf of the Board of Education, I would like to congratulate you on your graduation from Jackson Liberty High School. This is a completion of the first phase of your life filled with learning. I'd like to take a moment to thank the people of Jackson School community, which have played a part in marking tonight's possible accomplishments. The teachers, the support staff, the drivers, facility crews, the food service, the security teams, all those who work in the front and behind the scenes to get you where you are today. I'm sure you agree that we could not do this without them. Please give them an applause. For the last 12 plus years, you have learned to answer questions about what and how of life, like, what is the capital of Nebraska? How do you use a Punnett square? In the next phase, you will learn about who, as in who you are and who you want to be. Will you be the one who gives, or will you be the one who takes? Will you be the one who engages in life, or will you be the one who stands on the sidelines and watches? Graduated from Jackson School District in 1977, spent 34 years as a teacher, coach, administrator. I have also volunteered in many community organizations, which include being a Board of Education member. I tell you this to encourage you to volunteer in your community, to help the next generations of students learn by using your experience and knowledge. Also, by helping older generation, you will learn new things from them. Why you should be a volunteer: to enrich your education, to gain invaluable work experience, or because it will make you feel good about yourself. Not to mention the fact that it is a powerful networking tool and it looks great on a resume. I also give you a sense of purpose, helps you find opportunities you never knew existed, and most importantly, it will be making a difference in your community. You will be giving back. Some of you here tonight have already experienced some of these benefits of volunteering through the Key Club, Honor Society, and other clubs. We thank you for your efforts. I hope you realize that you have already made a difference. The Board of Education has worked hard alongside our administration, our teachers, and our support staff to give you the best foundations we can, but the rest is up to you. Whether you volunteer at your school, work at a local food pantry, with a church group, with scouts, coaching youngsters, tutoring other students, or helping the elderly, it's important to give back to your community. In the process, you are setting an example for others to emulate. As someone who once sat where you sit, I'd ask you to please remember that if you want to touch the past, touch a rock. If you want to touch the present, touch a flower. But if you want to touch the future, touch a life. I am confident that these amazing classes will just do that. In doing so, you will be using your passions and interests to make a difference. I promise you the experience will help you discover who you are and who you will be in the future will be. Congratulations, class of 2022.
Thank you, Mr. Walsh. Although you assemble here this evening as a group, it is altogether fitting that we should recognize two of your classmates individually for their accomplishments. Keeping with tradition, today we recognize the class valedictorian and salutatorian. This young woman is a dedicated, intelligent, extremely organized, and dependable individual. Her work ethic is tremendous, and she deserves to be recognized for her accolades. She has been on the high honor roll every semester for the past 4 years while enrolled in 9 AP and 12 honors courses, earning a 4.75 GPA. Been a member of the National Honor Society, where she is the public relations officer, Science National Honor Society, Mu Alpha Theta Math Honor Society, Rho Kappa Social Studies Honor Society, the Interact Club, Math League, STEM Club, Key Club, and Peer Assistance Leader. She volunteers her time with the Blessing Bag Brigade, Beach Sweeps, the Jackson Food Pantry, Back to School Night, and Adopt a Senior. And if this were not enough, she somehow finds time to work a part-time job at Party City. She's a remarkable, caring young woman who will be attending Rutgers University in the fall, and it is with great pleasure that I present to you the salutatorian for the class of 2022, Charlotte Orton.
Thank you, Mr. Brignola. I would like to begin by congratulating Jackson Liberty's graduating class of 2022. I know some of you have been wishing for this day to arrive ever since we walked into Liberty, and that many of you are excited for what the future holds, to the point where it is all many of you can think about without truly focusing on the now. Instead of focusing on the unknown future, I want to remind you of the extraordinary accomplishment it is to be receiving your diploma today and to be stepping forward into a new path of life. I, of course, would like to thank all the teachers, administration, and staff at Jackson Liberty High School for their support over the last 4 years. It has been a long journey, but I hope that you can look at our class and realize that all the work, hard work that you've put into the last 4 years has paid off now that you can see us graduate today. I would also like to thank parents, guardians, and the many others who have supported our graduates today. It cannot truly be put into words how appreciative we all are of the support you give us each and every day. I know many of us can hardly believe it's our time to finally sit on this field with our cap and gowns on, about to accept our diplomas. I could talk about how hard it was for us over the last 4 years and praise each and every one of you for achieving your goals during these difficult times. But the thing is, you already know how hard high school was. We all sat through many of the same courses, were taught by many of the same teachers, and took many of the same tests. And while, yes, it was a new challenge each and every day, it still was an incredible experience that has offered wonderful memories that will last a lifetime. When I look back at high school, I know that I will inevitably think about the hardships that I faced. I spent a lot of my time in high school stressed about due dates and exhausted from late nights doing homework. My parents would constantly tell me to enjoy the present and never wish it away in hopes for a better future. And while it's a little hard to admit, they're absolutely right. So to close out my speech, I want to offer a small piece of advice to our graduating class. In the coming years, no matter what you plan on doing or the places you choose to go, try to focus on the now rather than the later. This is the time of your lives to work hard, but never forget to have fun and truly enjoy the small things in life. This is the time to make mistakes, but to learn and grow from them. I know that each year we were always asked to think of the future, to plan ahead for college and for a career, but I ask that you never stop thinking about the now. Because today, right now, you will all be graduating high school. And for one moment, allow yourself to stop thinking and worrying about tomorrow and enjoy your accomplishments that you've made today. Once again, congratulations to Jackson Liberty Class of 2022 for this tremendous achievement.
Thank you, Charlotte. Great job. This young woman is extremely hardworking and conscientious, intelligent, caring, and as humble as you can find. She has accomplished so much in her 4 years at Jackson Liberty High School. On top of working extremely diligently in academics for the past 4 years, 9 AP and 11 honors courses, high honor roll for every semester of her high school, earning a 4.8 GPA, she is also a member of the National Honor Society, Mu Alpha Theta Math Honor Society, National Art Honor Society, Rho Kappa Social Studies Honor Society, French Honor Society, International Thespian Society, STEM Club, Interact Club, Key Club, Math Club, and a member of the Walksman Student Scholar Program at Rutgers University. She's a member of the girls' soccer team and the manager for the boys' ice hockey and lacrosse teams. She, too, has somehow found time with this busy schedule to perform volunteer work with Sanibel's Beach Sweeps, Blessing Bag Brigade, Jackson Food Pantry, and Cranberry Arts Council. She has interned with the Jackson Board of Education and the Jackson School District Energy Conservation, and she works at the Jersey Shore Howell Ice Arena. She will be attending Boston College in the fall, and we can't wait to see what the next chapter of her book will be. It is with great pleasure I present to you the valedictorian for the class of 2022, Ashley Waldron.
Thank you, Mr. Brignola. I'm so proud and honored to step up here today in front of all of you outstanding students, staff, administration, and family. Congratulations, class of 2022. We did it. I'd like to take a moment to thank all of those who had an impact on my and my peers' time here at Liberty. Thank you to all of the teachers and administrators who have taught us so much, not only about our academic subjects, but about ourselves. You've touched our lives, allowing us to flourish in our respective futures. Thank you to all of our families who have supported and guided us through these trying 4 years. We couldn't do it without you. And finally, thank you to my peers for an incredibly memorable high school experience. To me, high school, like life, is all about taking steps. From our first steps, which our parents may or may not have gotten on camera, to that misstep on the sidewalk where we scraped our knees, to the steps onto the bus for the first day of school. 4 years ago, we made the step up to high school after our eighth grade graduation. From the first time freshman year that we stepped through the bus ramp doors, to the steps up to the podium at the front of our English classes every year to make a speech, and to the steps made here today, walking to earn our diplomas and leaving this school for the last time as students. Although there are many steps to come, those chapters of our stories are yet to be written. So be proud of the ones you've taken, the ones that led you here today. Getting to know many of you over the years, I have observed the passions and drive each of you have. I hope that you will always hold on to your aspirations and pursue all of your wildest dreams. I hope you never give up on the things that matter most to you, and I hope you never have any regrets. Try to not to be intimidated by impossibility. Instead, be motivated by opportunity. You've put in the work to get to this point, and now it's your time. So go out there and take it. Every one of you has a gift, whether it's math or dance, a sport or art. Your gift matters. The question I have for you is, will you have the courage to grasp it? Will you take that chance on yourself and harness your gift? If you don't, you sell not only yourself, but the whole world short. Doubt has been the death of more dreams than failure ever could be. Will there be struggles? Yes, there's no way around it. Much like that misstep on the sidewalk, you will trip and fall many times, but who's counting? Rarely ever do you see a straight road. It is the twists and turns that make the journey the most beautiful. Have faith in yourself as you choose where your next steps take you. This day marks a turning point in all of our lives. It is now that we must open a whole new chapter of our books. It is now that we must take more steps than ever before. And as we all move on towards the rest of our lives, I encourage each and every one of you to dream big, believe in yourselves, and never be afraid to take that next step. Congratulations, class of 2022, and thank you.
Thank you, Ashley. Once again, welcome to the 2022 Jackson Liberty graduation celebration. There's a fable about a carrot, an egg, and coffee beans that talks about dealing with adversity. The fable goes something like this. Consider how differently carrots, eggs, and ground coffee beans are affected by the extreme adversity of being boiled. Like a carrot, adversity can soften us. We can emerge more flexible, understanding, compassionate, and grateful, or we can let our life spirit turn into a soft mush. Like an egg, boiling water can make us harder, stronger, tougher, and wiser, or we can become more cynical, pessimistic, callous, and inaccessible. And like coffee beans, whose structure is completely transformed by the boiling water, do we see that transformation as something better, like the delicious coffee it produces, or do we view it as losing ourselves completely? I believe the class of 2022 has taken on all of the positive characteristics that the carrot, egg, and coffee beans went through when confronted with adversity. How do I know this? Because you are sitting here with your peers in front of your family, friends, and Liberty faculty and staff as the 2022 Jackson Liberty High School graduating class. 3/4 of the way through your sophomore year, the world changed before your eyes. The following year, pretty much everything you knew about school was supposed to be, in-person classes with teachers and classmates, sports, clubs, dances, competitions, formals, proms, had changed. Then just when everything was supposed to get back to normal, your senior year, that normalcy was put on hold yet again. Although things are almost back to the normal we once knew, what you have accomplished over the past 4 years, but more specifically the past 2.5 years, is to be commended, especially in lieu of all the difficult circumstances that were put in your way. The resiliency you have exhibited has been nothing less than outstanding and what makes us, the Jackson Liberty family, so proud. Whether you know it or not, you dealt with adversity of the pandemic, and there were many forms that this took to become more flexible, understanding, compassionate, grateful, stronger, tougher, wiser, and overall more beautiful and better able to live more meaningful and successful lives. Were there times where you felt like your life spirit was turning into a soft mush? Where you felt more cynical, pessimistic, callous, and inaccessible? Where you thought you were completely losing yourselves? I'm sure there were many moments of these feelings. That's human nature. However, you did not allow the adversity to erode your capacity to be successful and happy. You could not control the circumstances that were happening around you, but you had a lot to say about how to react, and therefore controlling the circumstances that happened to you. You didn't dwell and mope on the negatives. You didn't let misfortune define your life. You forced yourself to move forward. You drew on your inner strengths. You sought the love and support of your family, as well as that from your teachers and counselors, and you accomplished great successes along the way, although you were confronted with several years of boiling water adversity. You succeeded on the athletic fields with several of our teams winning divisions as well as setting new team records. You succeeded in the band. You were state champions and the leader of the New York City St. Patrick's Day Parade and countless other awards. You succeeded in the arts. The play and musical were back and were wonderful, with packed live audiences, and our art shows wowed all who had the privilege to see the incredible talents of our students. You succeeded socially by once again hosting live events for all to enjoy. You held the first ever outdoor homecoming dance, the Halloween show, the talent show, the holiday spectacular, Spirit Weeks. Boy, did we have Spirit Weeks or what? Dodgeball tournament, Ferronis, and so many fundraisers and volunteer work reaching out to the community to help countless worthy causes and those in need. And you succeeded academically. You won awards and scholarships and were awarded acceptances into colleges and universities across the country, or the trade schools, or right into the workforce or students entering the military, and you were able to do this all while navigating the ever-changing world around you. You have strengthened our Liberty family and forged new legacies, and we can't thank you enough. At this time, I would like to have all the students who will be entering our military please stand and be recognized. We'd like to thank you for all the sacrifices you will be making for our country, and we pray for your safety and thank you all in advance for your service. Thank you. Parents and guardians, we'd also like to thank you for all of your patience, understanding, and support through such difficult times. You have been unwavering in your love and commitment to your children and the characteristics you instilled in them. And this we are grateful. For this we are grateful. Class of 2022, I think it only appropriate for you to show your appreciation and love for these very important people in your lives who have helped and supported you along the way. Class of 2022, there's another group of people, your Liberty family, your teachers who are in attendance today, who have helped foster the characteristics you will take with you in the future and your future endeavors. I'd like to take a moment to recognize our teachers. Teachers, please stand. Thank you for your dedication, compassion, understanding, and courage to make sure our students were able to get through the instruction, learning, and care they needed during the time here at Liberty. Your commitment to our students has been nothing but inspirational, and I want to say thank you. Seniors, please know that your Liberty family will always care for you and will always be here for you. Thank you. A few of these teachers need to be individually recognized today. Mrs. Gibson and Ms. Smink, please stand. Mrs. Gibson, congratulations for being named this year's Jackson Liberty High School's Teacher of the Year, and Mrs. Smink, congratulations for being named this year's Educational Services Professional of the Year. Both of you exhibited a love and compassion for our Liberty students that is second to none. Thank you for all that you continue to do for Liberty, and congratulations on your much-deserved awards. To someone in the crowd tonight, Officer Pajowski, even though we are lucky enough to have you as a security guard now, as our SRO, thank you for all that you have done with all of our students and staff over the years and making sure our safety and security were your top priority. Lastly, Ms. Keegan and Ms. Salazar, unfortunately, couldn't be here today, but you have dedicated yourselves to the students of Jackson Liberty High School and the Jackson School District for the last 20 years. Enjoy your retirement, and please know on behalf of all of us here today, you will be missed. I'd also like to wish our Director of Guidance, Kurt Holtz, and our Transition Facilitator, Jan Jasperger, all the best in their retirements. Class of 2022, you have seen over the past 4 years the world is ever-changing, at times difficult and filled with adversity, but also times of great joy and pride. What you have shown all of us is that you have become stronger, more compassionate, understanding, wiser, and ready for the challenges that lie ahead. Your belief in yourselves will allow you to achieve any dream, and I am confident that there will be many dreams achieved in all of your futures, and I look forward to hearing about the happy, beautiful, and successful lives you have created. Thank you all for being Liberty Lion Strong and part of our Liberty family for the last 4 years, and I wish you nothing but the best. Congratulations, class of 2022. Mrs. Pormilli, Mr. Walsh, and members of the Jackson Township Board of Education, as principal of Jackson Liberty High School, I, Jeffrey Brignola, present to you the class of 2022. I certify that the eligible young men and women before you have fulfilled the graduation requirements set forth by the state of New Jersey and by the Jackson Township Board of Education and are prepared to receive their diplomas. The time has now come for you, the class of 22, to accept your well-deserved recognition as graduates by receiving your diplomas. The diplomas this evening will be presented by Ms. Pormilli and board members assisted by the senior class officers. Ms. Kathy Cavanaugh, advisor of the class of 2022, would you please come to the podium?
In keeping with the tradition of commencement, the valedictorian and salutatorian will be the first in their class to receive their diplomas. Class of 2022, valedictorian, Ashley Marie Waldron. Class of 2022, salutatorian, Charlotte R. Orton. Student Council Co-President Samantha Diamond. Student Council Co-President Kimberly Stallworth. Senior Class President Emma Canis. Senior Class Vice President Taylor Calderwood. Sorry, Taylor. Senior Class Vice President Emma Idle. Senior Class Vice President Sophia Quinones. Senior Class Vice President Cheyenne H. Thayer.
Sarah Valentina Alargra Contreras. Yasir Azburadi. Ashley Michelle Amador. Christopher Andrews. Nicole Ashley Andrews. Yerlin Y. Aparizio. AJ Aradula. Fatima Nicole Ariano. Nelson Arias. Alyssa Marie Ario. Anastasia Artemenko. Genesis Atienza. Omar Atia. Justin S. Bailey. Valerie Yasmin Banuelos Martinez. Gianni Baragan. Deborah Antonella Barrara. Anthony Basilico. Marissa Bastian. Ayendi Batista. Christopher Robert Beals. Daniel Benson. Ariani Bentecourt McQueaver. Parker Blackmore. Elijah James Blackwell. Brandon Bone. Vance Bonneau. Vincent Bonacor Udut. India Lee Bella Berlongen. Joaquin Robert Berlongen. Joseph D. Bradley. Kevin S. Brzezinskis. Gabrielle Alexandra Broughton. William Bryce. Ariana Butler. Alyssa Kainzos. Julie Rose Cayoza. Delaney Calderon. Alyssa Cameron. Elton Kanka. Dylan Kanata. Jessica Ann Canestro. Ava Marie Cano. Gianna Marie Cardone. Danny Alexandra Casper. Jacqueline Cassidy. Carly Castelli. Matthew Castro. Nicholas Wilson Catneys. Mark Daniela Celestin. Ella Faith Santafanti.
Sarah Satine. Dylan Chapman. Zachary Cho. Sarah G. Christie. Dalir Tarumov. Michael A. Chicarillo III. Elijah Jared Matthias Clay. Nicholas Conti. Arturo Corona. Lara Costa. Elena Kaylee Covey. Ashley Suzette Cusimano. Fabiana D'Amico. Katrina Isabella D'Antonio. Armand Zarella. Gianna Rose Da Silva. Quinn William Dodelin. Megan Julia DiCarlo. Ian Spencer Della Penna. Dominique Paige DeLucia. Ruan Victor D'Souza. Jonathan Devine. Gloria Michelle Diaz Sanchez. Julian Diaz. Angelique Denal. Tony Dornhard. Garrett Flynn Drew. Jasenia Dueno. Sean Duffy. Jack Duke. Sarah Duke. Phanique Dupree Jr. Kaylin Ellis. Vanessa Enriquez Guerrero. Kyle Fail. Rebecca Falk. Hunter Daniel Fanter. Jaden Ellis Farley. Jaleesa Brianna Farley. Josiah William Farley. Emily Jewel Fatera. Christopher John Raphael Fell. Martin Figueroa. Nasir Fitzpatrick. Shamel Sheldon Flavany. Esmeralda Flores. Jose Lazaro Flores Tiros. Jose Luis Flores Tiros. Kevin Flynn. Lacey Paige Flynn. Alexander Dennis Gablix.
Connor A. Gallagher. Vito Galena Jr. Alfred Samuel Galvin. Barrett M. Garcia. Ethan R. Garcia. Devin Grayson Gazarowski. Kayo Geronimo. Santino M. Joya. Jason A. Giovanetti. Alan Gomez. Sherlyn Gomez. Renata Gonzalez. Layla Katrina Gonzalez Fernandez. Natalie Gray. Ariana Renee Griesi. Thomas Raymond Guida. Christina Gunnison. Alyssa Guzman. Karime Hernandez Benitez. Lorelai Teresa Hilarczyk. Kira Lee Holder. Brian T. Huerta. Elizabeth G. Huff. Blake Perry Hyman. Mushfiqul Islam. Sanai Gabrielle Jackson. Francisco No Jalapa Cruz. Lauren Nicole Jansen. Isabella Javier. Kenneth Calipos. Ariana Kalucki. Craig L. Karpinski. Matt Kavanaugh. Celine B. Kavas. Lydia Kellyman. Anthony Christopher Keneally. Abigail Kennis. Abigail Rose Kisberth. Michael Kuderick. Mina Kovac. Peyton Kowalczyk. Hunter Jake Kowalski. Dennis Curtis. Haley M. Kurzenberger. Hector J. LeBoy Rodriguez. Michael Eric Legary. Madison Lang. Christopher Lee Jr. Justin C. Lee. Taylor Lazinski. Vivian Marie Levine. Ivan Latovsky. Guy Lubernicki.
Alana Maglinoff. Isabella M. Mayton. Emily Elizabeth Makeley. Cole Thomas Malinowski. Jennifer Mata Robles. Ada Yolibeth Mayorga. Emily Samari Mayorga. Mark McLean. Teresa Mayado Perez. Betzeda Mendoza Torres. Woo! Victoria R. Meyer. Maurice McHale. Gerardo Monez Quechol. Sean Morrow. Colleen Nagy. Carly Marie Nelson. Dakota Jesse Knowles. Jordan Alyssa Newman. Scott Newman. Lara Marie Newton. Kaylee Nugent. David S. Noodleman. Juan Olivares. Lily J. Olson. Amanda Orena. Brooke Osamina. Mark Osamina. Matthew Panabianco. Mitt J. Patel. Vincent Pollack. Tyler Perez. Ryan Edward Perry. Mario Petamaritis. Olivia Parag. Linda Caitlin Prizer. Dakario Pritchett. Dante Joseph Rayo. Joanny L. Ramirez. Caitlin Elizabeth Rayside. Antonio Reynoso. Diamond Nastasia Reyes. Michael Rizzo. Emma Paige Rizzo Troxel. Dante Joseph Roberto. Elise Rodriguez. Sarah Rodriguez. Ariana Rolnick. Matthew Romero. Alexis Maria Romito. Tyler Jordan Rozovsky. Zachary J. Rowan. Kayla Marie Ryan.
Gallup Sadiku. Rebecca Haley Sadowski. Kirillos Ahmad Saeed. Grace J. Salko. Avon Sanders. Avery Sanders. Haley Santos. Christopher A. Sasso. Hannah Schneider. Peter Shelto. Anna Sorganina. Sonia Sheikh. Gianna Emily Shave.
Katie Shepherd. Trinity Ann Shepherd. Wasley Silva. Madison Maria Simmons. Joseph Michael Scamangus. Christian L. Smith. Caitlin Marie Smith. Robert William Smith, Jr. Viviana Soriano Huevera. Joseph Carlos Souza. Michael Thomas Southon. Kenyon Jeremiah Stokes. Yusef Takoy. Zachary Taylor. Azuzena Tejada. Brian Matthew Thornley. Laura Turpak. Adam Gabriel Giuliano. Shane Urso. Colin R. Vallister. Bianca Marie Vargas. Carolyn Vashi. Ronald Jake Vashi. Caitlin Velez. Luz Maria Victoriano Grande. M. Victoria Villalobos V. Leah Gianna Vogel. Hannah Volchik. Justin Watts. Evan Weisskopf. Dallas Christopher Weiss. Cross Jaden Alexander White. Jaden Marie Wilcox. Channing Williams. Shayna Yerrick. Cooper York. John Euro. J.
Joseph Francesco Zappia. Joseph Zawada.
Please stand. Congratulations, class of 2022. You have now earned the honor of shifting the tassel on your cap from the right side to the left. Please begin your recessional by moving towards the end zone at this time.
Go meet your guest in the end zone.